Hello, hi, how are you today? I'm Patricia McNeely, located in Chicago, Illinois. So today, we're still in the beginning part of the year. I don't know about you, but 2022 was really intense. However, this year has a lot of auspicious elements to it already. But here's what I want to talk to you about, going into the past. In my 15 years of doing work with people and being a metaphysical healer, a metaphysician, all the things that I've learned and studied and written about, there's one thing that a lot of people don't even know that they're supposed to address, and that is their past lives. Now, what is it about our past? Well, number one, it repeats itself. Those who are repeating history, you know, those who do not learn from the past are doomed to repeat it. But what if you don't even know what it is that you're repeating? What if it is a manner of death? Because this is what I also find. Your body has a memory of those things, of what killed you, of what you suffered from, of the traumas, and it starts remembering. These are sometimes triggering events, and even psychologists and the medical community do not know about these things. There is the health of your physical body, because that is the anchoring for your light body, your chakras, your karma points, and your love connections. Other things that have to do with your past include your ancestry and how that actually plays out into modern life. What have your people suffered? What have traumatized them? What cataclysms have they suffered from? And so, yes, I can do a past life regression. Yes, I've had past life regressions. Many times, a past life regression is a focus on a particular area of your body. What I'm proposing to you is utilize the brand new aspect of your own brand new light body, your brand new blueprint for relationship, and get some healing and learn how to do it again and again. And I'll tell you why. Because at every retrograde cycle, even if you cringe, even if you're like, oh, Mercury's in retrograde, or, you know, there's like a running joke between me and my son where he has started noticing. He's like, hey, the thing didn't print, or hey, my phone is going wonky, or hey, I had this weird communication. And he starts saying this. He's like, don't even tell me Mercury's in Gatorade. That's the joke. Instead of retrograde, he kind of flipped it around and calls it Gatorade, right? But the key thing being, no matter if he's superstitious or not superstitious, he's noticing. We're noticing that there are influences upon our life and our environment that sometimes are a little bit beyond our control. That doesn't mean that it has to be shadowy or creepy. It means learning how to navigate it with your light body, because you are in a state of transition. You're literally going from an old paradigm to a brand new level of experience, a brand new level of health, a brand new level of living. And so if you carry the past with you, guess what? You start repeating patterns. You continue meeting the same old people. You try to date and they're all the same people, even if they have different names and different faces. They have, why is this? Because you're carrying the patterns with you. What about illnesses that your body is remembering? Okay. Now, science is noticing this. Science is noticing that people who smoke, if they pick up smoking again, they start altering their tissues again, right? That's almost a no-brainer, except there is scientific research to back it up. That is one of my dreams, which is to actually take the work of others and extend it beyond, so that you have, you know, more like proof. You have a body of proof in the sense of people who have transformed, they've up-leveled themselves, and they are not suffering those things. They've somehow nipped it in the bud. They've somehow dodged that bullet. So if your body is remembering something, or you have a combination of actual memories, memories that seem out of context with your current situation, you feel like your throat is closing, you're frozen, You're in a you're dreaming of a battlefield. You're dreaming that people are like somehow pushy with you. You're dreaming of being attacked, or you're having weird kind of a sexual subtext undertone to the dream, but it's weird. It's creepy. It's off-putting. And you're saying, that's not sacred at all. Why am I being subjected to this? These are important things. And yet without a context, you can't really properly utilize it to heal yourself. Now, one of the differences between just having a one-time thing, like I say, it's going to be a focus on one thing. It'll probably be most prominent, like you're dealing with an addiction or you're dealing with a family situation. I extend my class over 3 weeks, and this gives you time to develop and integrate your body, okay? Time to understand it. Time to have like a go-to tool so that you can use it again in retrograde. We are going forward on some of the retrograde energy from 2022. For some people, it was a return to like a semblance of normalcy. We're never going to have a new normal again until you're in love. Okay. But when I say in love, that doesn't mean just shacking up with someone or having someone in your house. What this means is where you're enveloped in your light body to the degree that you feel inside that love. You are, what's in the inner is the outer, and the outer and above is now in the inner. Okay. You have to get these parts of you together because they are moving parts. They're not really separate parts of you, although it can feel separate at times. Like I say, out of context, abstract, not really able to connect the dots. Some of the other things that we talk about, you may have heard the term Akashic Records. What does this mean? Probably the simplest explanation I can give you is an analogy. To think of an encyclopedia or almost an instantaneous Googling of your experiences, experiences that are good, and believe it or not, other people's experiences from the collective. There's levels of this too, because some of it is universal, meaning it's universal to all of us. Some of it is very personal, like your dating life. Like how would you let your light body sift and sort the candidates for you? I mean, are you playing Russian roulette with Tinder or some other thing out there? Because you're up to here with this journey. I don't recommend it. I recommend engaging your light body and letting your light body do that sorting for you, do the deflection so you're avoiding awkward conversations, right? Because the things of the past will come to haunt you. Who have you had to marry? What is your tradition? What about your tribal connections, right? And maybe it's not suiting your modern life and you really know you're here to be with someone. So we want to bring that positive part of everything that you have in your own repository called the Akashic Records. Some of the other things that give you hints and clues, deja vu, repetitive dreams, birthmarks. We're going to get deep. And so I am offering a class. Now, let me tell you something else. And this was so cool for me because I had someone I was working with, and she was originally from Saudi Arabia. And so there was a different culture than I grew up in. There was a different language than I even know. My awareness, you could say, of the Middle East was formed by some really great friendships and the food. I love Middle Eastern food, right? But every country is a little bit different. And we had the topic because people were so interested. The ladies were so interested in past lives. Here's the kicker. They're not raised on it. As an Irish Catholic, I was kind of raised on this, especially the Irish part. Okay, like we liked, there's a lot of people that, I was just thinking about this. They want to talk to Hindu gods or Greek gods or Egyptian gods or something like that. There's minor and major deities from every culture, right? So the Irish have theirs, the Vikings had theirs, the Slavic people had theirs, every culture, right? Here's the thing. Some of that carries over to modern times in the sense that you kind of get a mashup within the religious tradition with what has been more of a nature religion, more of a philosophy and a theology that incorporates much more of the natural and the supernatural world, which has not been able to explain. So this is very true of the Celtic and the Irish people. There's a strong belief in what is beyond the scope of your human eyes. What does your dream time show up? What does your, if you're in grief, what happens? You know, and now some of it can certainly be flavored by superstitions, but how do you sift out the kernels of truth for yourself? It's through working on your light body. You keep what's true, you discard the mind trash. Now, I was raised, so getting back to this class that we did, I was sort of raised with a little bit of belief in reincarnation. It was very normal in the circle I grew up in. It wasn't normal for a lot of other people. And in fact, I found out years later that some of that was discouraged just in order to kind of keep people, you know, obedient and loyal and so forth. But people have these nagging memories, and it's in other cultures. And I came to find out it is so vividly real. I consider it to be the absolute reason in our root cause. If you want to find the root cause of something, I know how to dig it out. And it's by touch, that is my gift. So I was really nervous because in their tradition, in some of the Middle Eastern countries where people were participating in the class online, I didn't know how to present it at first. And so I asked for the guidance, and the guidance told me what to write, how it would translate so simply, how to develop this in people, and how to help them have real experiences that really hit their heart, that really gave them that immersion effect so that they could see and that they could start changing that one thing in their backstory so that it could move forward and improve the situation. And by the end of the 3 to 4 weeks, we were having some really miraculous results. Things that, you know, if you want to wave a magic wand, it was even better than we hoped for, because we were incorporating much higher energies, much higher love energy, okay? This is a part of the past that people really don't give credence to. Your higher self wants you to rid yourself of the past, wants you to lighten the load and move up. That is ascension. What do you discard? What do you keep? How do you do this integration so that you're really doing some self-healing and maintenance and still up-leveling yourself and still attending to your responsibilities and favorable outcomes? What is the one thing that will transform your DNA? Your light body, okay? Not only that, it is a new light body that wants to hold love and not misery, if that makes sense. I mean, it's that simple. Swap out the old, swap in the new. But it is a process, and it is a process of learning, because you have to learn so that you can do the maintenance, so that the next time a retrograde hits, you're kind of rolling up your sleeves and you're saying, hey, what can I do to be able to utilize this energy wisely and not feel like I'm getting tumbled around in the washing machine? In April, there is a huge energy coming in. There's going to be a lot that happens. It's going to be very similar of being at a crossroads. Now, if you're someone who studies astrology, this would be similar to opposing forces. It'll feel like something's, you know, wanting to give, and there's resistance, and then there's opposition. And it's just going to be intense for a lot of people. Would you like to get one step ahead of that and be able to learn and have some tools and some go-to things and some movement and the how-to, right? Because it's not just book knowledge. I mean, naturally, our minds want answers. We need to apply words to things. But on this journey, so much more happens that is, it can be felt physically, but it's non-physical, okay? You're not pulling out some runes. You're not rolling dice. You're not using a pendulum. You're using your naturally gifted divine connections for moving forward. Okay, this is a gift. It's an honor to be here and a privilege. But yes, like anything, if someone presented you with a new bike, you'd have to get up and ride it and practice it till you're like good and you're going. This is what your light body is. It has a lot of bells and whistles and it's time to do it. This isn't going to be about identifying the narcissist and analyzing it to death till you feel sick to your stomach. This is about you. This is about making you better and feeling good and letting the energy reside at your heart level and letting that lift you up, not letting your mind drag you down. So we use some words because naturally there is a presentation. Another thing I love, I just absolutely love this. When I do classes, webinars, when people talk about their dreams and they share their experiences, it is off the charts. We have so much fun. A lot of times we run over time. Nobody seems to mind. I mean, as much as, you know, we want to stay on track and not, you know, have overkill or, you know, talk something to death, giving opportunity for you to ask me and get intuitive answers, get responses, get me to lead you into your true feelings, your true answers. This is fabulous. It's fabulous for me because it is true empowerment. It is true self-healing where you feel empowered and confident. If you want your natural confidence back, if you want to, you know, get the blocks from the past, please join. Please see the link below. Please see some of the things that I've already written about it and join us. First 10 people get a discount. So hope you join us. If you have questions, please reach out. My email is in the description and watch for my next videos. We're going to talk about some things that are pertinent to this. Past, present, future, but mainly your future. Let's unclick the past and cut cords with it, shall we? Thanks so much. Have a great day. Bye.